Hey everyone! 6 months ago, Talking Sasquatch did a video on the Flipboard, and I'm excited to announce the apps are now available in the official store. We have a Blinky Badge app, a sub-gigahertz and infrared remote, a memory game, and a USB or Bluetooth low energy keyboard that also doubles as a music keyboard. In this video, I'll walk through each of the apps and also show how to customize them. Let's get started! The Flipboard is a macro pad accessory for your Flipper Zero. It's available on Make It Hacken's Etsy and Tindy stores. I recommend buying the kit and building it yourself. It just takes a couple of minutes and you'll be more familiar with the switches. On lab.flipper.net, click Apps, then GPIO, and you should be able to find the four Flipboard applications. I recommend using Chrome or Edge as your browser, as it will give you the option to install directly onto the Flipper Zero. You can also use the mobile app. Just click on Hub, then click on Apps, and then click on GPIO. And scroll till you find the Flipboard app you want, click Install, and then click on GPIO again to see the progress. I recommend checking your firmware before installing the apps. For example, Roguemaster under GPIO already has a Flipboard folder with the applications pre-installed. Flipboard Blinky turns your Flipboard into a wearable badge. Make It Hacken has this cool badge holder that you can buy when you order your Flipboard, or you can 3D print one yourself. When the app starts, it shows a splash screen to remind you to connect the Flipboard. We'll look at each app using the default configuration, and then we'll go back and configure the apps. The first two buttons change the speed of the lights, and the last button goes to the next effect, and the third button will go back to the previous effect. Pressing both buttons turns off the lights. As I mentioned, we're going to look at the default configuration, but we'll look at configure application later. About shows you the version of the application. Instructions QR code takes you to the GitHub page. Next, we'll look at the Flipboard Keyboard app. Again, it shows the splash screen when the application starts. And then we click on Start Application. It's a USB macro pad. By default, the first button prints a welcome message. I'll press Enter on my keyboard. The second button is a link to our Discord server. The third button is a link to my YouTube channel. And the fourth button is a link to Make It Hacken's YouTube channel. Later, we'll learn to customize the messages, use Bluetooth Low Energy, and turn it into a musical keyboard. Next, we have Flipboard Signal, which turns your Flipboard into a sub-gigahertz and infrared remote. By default, it's a universal TV remote. The first button is Power, second button is Mute, third button is Previous Channel, and the fourth button is the Next Channel. We'll configure different infrared and sub-gigahertz devices later in the video. The final application we'll show is Flipboard Simon, which is a memory game. This application is also a written tutorial where you can learn how to make the video game yourself and learn Flipboard programming. Now let's take a look at how to configure each of the applications. Flipboard Simon has four actions. Action 1 is the first button. Action 2 is the second button. Action 4 is the third button. And Action 8 is the fourth button. Let's go ahead and configure the leftmost button. So Action 1. And you can see we have a press color when you press the button down and a music note. So we'll pick G sharp octave 3 for our music note. And instead of green, we'll switch it to violet. So now when we press the back button, that information is saved. And when we start our application now, you'll notice the first button is no longer green. Next, we'll look at how to configure the Flipboard Signal application. The Flipboard Signal application is a little bit different because it supports combinations of buttons. So we have an action 3 for when button 1 and 2 are pressed together. And then we have action 4 like before, and then action 5 for button 1 and 3. Action 6 for 2 and 3, action 7, etc. So there's 15 different actions. We have a press color, a release color, and a note. To configure infrared, we're going to go into apps, and then we'll go down to infrared, and then we'll choose learn new remote. And so now it's scanning for an infrared remote. We'll press the button. There it is. We click save, and then you'll get prompted to name the button. Type in flip 1 through flip 15, corresponding to the action number that you want this to be associated with. So in this case, we'll use flip 1, which is the leftmost button. So the leftmost button will be our on. Then we'll go to plus, press the next button on the remote, choose save, and this time we'll use flip 2 for the name of our button. So this will be the second button on our flipboard. If we had also named this flip 1, then it would play the two infrared signals one after each other. And this is a nice trick to make a small universal remote that works quickly. Once you're done, you're going to choose edit, go down to rename remote, and delete the existing name of the remote, and then name it flipboard. Once you've saved this, you'll also be able to do load save remotes and load your flipboard remote in the future if you want to add additional buttons. Once it's saved, you can back out and exit the infrared application. Next, we'll program the flipper for the sub-gigahertz remotes. So we'll go into the sub-gigahertz application, go into read, go into configure, and configure your frequency and modulation however is required by your remote. Then press a button on the remote, and then you can press the next button as well if you'd like. We'll go back to that first signal, click OK, and then click the right arrow to save, and then name the signal flip 1 through flip 15, depending on which action you'd like to save it as. In this case, I'll use flip 4, so that's the third button. And then once I've saved that successfully, I'll go to the next signal, I'll click save, and I'll name this one flip 8, which is the fourth button. These are actual file names, so you can only have one button named for one action. Now we're ready to test our signals. So I'll send that infrared signal, and then I'll go ahead and send the sub-gigahertz signal to the light. Infrared to turn off, and sub-gigahertz. Next, we'll look at customizing Flipboard Blinky. There's our splash screen. We'll go down to Configure Application. Assets is the default name tag you saw earlier. We'll change our source to text, and our justification could be left, center, or right. I'll go down to line 2, and I'll enter the text hello. And then on line 3, I'll enter the text world. Again, we're currently using right justification. So I'll go ahead and click back, and then start application. And there's our Hello World badge. We can go back into Configure Application and choose Center Text. And this time it's centered. Back in Configuration, we'll switch Display Source to FXBM. And then we'll exit the application since we're going to upload a new file. Back in the store, we'll click on Flipboard Blinky, scroll down. Copy this first URL that's in creating an FXBM file. We'll paste that link. And then we will click on download the raw file. And then you'll choose keep if the script looks safe. Next, we'll open a command prompt. Go cd downloads into our download directory. There's the Python file we just downloaded. I also have a black and white 64 by 64 image. And I'm going to name that blinky.png. And if we open that, you can see it's just a small little 64 by 64 black and white image. This image can be up to 128 by 64. Next, we'll type Python and the name of our Python script. And you can see it created a blinky.fxbm file. I'll open QFlipper and I'll navigate to SD card, apps underscore data, Flipboard. And then I'll move QFlipper out of the way. We'll do start dot to see our current files. And then we'll drag the FXBM file from Windows Explorer into our QFlipper application. Now that our image file has been copied to our Flipper, we're ready to launch the Flipboard Blinky application. We'll go to Configure Application, FXBM, and Center. That looks good. And then we'll go ahead and say Start Application, and there's our new image. We can also go to Configure Application and change the justification. I'll do left justification. And now when we start it, it's on the left. In the future, I hope to make image uploading even easier. We're on the final app, which is Flipboard Keyboard. Our first customization is using BLE. Before we click on Start Application, unplug the USB cable from your Flipper Zero. Then go ahead and click on Start Application on the Flipper. Then on your computer, go into Bluetooth and say Add a Bluetooth device. Click on Add Device and then choose Bluetooth. You should see Bad USB followed by the name of your Flipper. On your Flipper, if the codes match, click the OK button. And then back on the Add Device in Windows, click on Connect. Hopefully you'll see a connected message. And then if that's happening, we'll go to Notepad. And now I'll click a button and there's no wires on my Flipper Zero. Next, we'll go into Configure Action, and you can see that the buttons include combinations. Under Action 4, you can see that we can set the press color, the released color, the musical note to play when the button's pressed. The keystroke is message 1, which will be sent one time. And we can add new keystrokes. And in message 1, you can see is my YouTube URL. You can see there's also a message 2, 3, and 4 that you can set with different texts that you would like. So let's change our configuration. So instead of using keystroke message 1, we'll use the Windows key. And then one time, and then we'll go to add keystroke, click OK. And you can see there's a little mini keyboard here with all the different characters. We'll go up to the top row and choose R. So Windows R brings up the run menu. And then we'll go ahead and say add keystroke. And this time we'll use the left and right arrows and we'll choose delay. And each delay is 100 milliseconds. So I'll say 8 for 800 milliseconds. And then we'll say add another keystroke. And this time we want to type in our message 1. And then add a keystroke. We'll press OK and we'll go over to the enter button. Okay. And we'll do that for a count of one time as well. So again, we're going to do left Windows R, which brings up the run menu, delay 800 milliseconds, type in our message 1, and then press enter. And that's action 4, which is button 3. We'll go ahead and start our application. And now, hopefully you can see this in focus. I'll press button 3. And there's the website. This last demonstration is how to play songs using the Flipboard. And so we're going to configure each of these actions for the different music notes that are listed. There's 13 actions that are listed, and these are combinations of buttons. And then also make sure you've set the count to 0 for all of your keystrokes so that it doesn't type while you're playing a song. Thanks again for watching this video about the various Flipboard apps. Please leave a comment about which features you'd like to see added for the Flipboard. And also don't forget to enter my Discord server for giveaways.